What's up guys, it's Ade. Now let's see who's suggesting the topic this week.
What's up Ade, it's Millie from The Office and I'm out in Nice watching the Women's World Cup finals. What I want to know this week is why the Lionesses and other female sports players aren't paid as much as the men. Take it easy.
Thanks Millie, that's right. This one is all about the gender pay gap in sport. The gender pay gap exists in a number of industries and describes the difference in pay between the average male and female worker. In sport, the pay gap is considerably big. For example, men's basketballers earn 93 times more than the women, and the prize money for the Women's Football World Cup is $30 million compared to the men's $400 million. This has led to the US women's soccer team filing a lawsuit against their own governing body, and the Aussie women's Matildas boycotting matches in order to bring attention to their gender pay gap. So should these women be paid the same as men? One of the main arguments against this is that pay for sports people isn't necessarily based on the work put in or the quality of the individual, but the marketability of their sport. In other words, the more people watch your sport, the more valuable the sport becomes to advertisers and the more money the athletes involved will receive. So pay is linked to viewing figures, right? The amount of people watching equals how much you'll get paid. Well, not necessarily. The prize money in the Men's Football World Cup is 17 times more than the women's, but the viewing figures for the competitions were only 4 times as many. So if it was down to viewing figures, the men would get paid more, but only 4 times more, not 17. The other argument is that men and women's sports are just not comparable. Male and female athletes have very different body types, and so in most sports, we can't expect women to be challenging men's records, something that a lot of people say makes women's sports less exciting. But do you think we're really thinking about how much less exciting it is when Nikita Paris is banging in goals like this?
Paris, step behind the defence, flag is down, shot at the goal, England leads!
So what a lot of this debate comes down to is how do we decide how much to pay people? Do you pay them for the work they put in to create their product? For example, how many teams they beat to win a trophy? Or do you pay them for the demand for the product? So the pay gap in sport is clearly a big issue, but what do you think? Should we be paying women as much as men? And with more financial incentives, would our Lionesses have a better chance of bringing it home? Let me know in the comments below and don't forget to like, share, subscribe and follow. Easy.